Hi everyone. Good morning children. So this is for class 6 standard. Subject is science and the lesson is sorting materials into groups. This is the fourth lesson of your class. Today we are going to discuss about this topic, that is sorting materials into groups. So in this lesson we are going to discuss, that is introduction of the lesson, materials, appearance, hardness, floating property, solubility, transparency and grouping of objects. Okay, so these are the main important aspects that we are going to study in this lesson. First we will start with the introduction. Children, so you might have seen this place. Yes, what is this? We can say this is as a mall. Yes, so this is the place where you can see a movie, buy clothes, accessories and enjoy a variety of a delicious food under one roof. Yes, so can you name this place? You know that what is this place? This is which we are called as what? Mall. Yes, so we call this place as a mall, and it is a place where all the objects are grouped systematically. Yes, so you might have seen that they, in this area there all the objects should be grouped in a systematically. Okay, so let us examine the objects around us and the materials that are used to make them. So what are these materials? Let us see. See, around us we can see many objects like car, flower. Yes, so many objects that we can see around us, like chair, football. Yes, and books. So these are the things and these are the objects which are in different shapes, size and different colors. Yes, and it's different accessories. So do you know that objects are made up of materials? Yes, the objects that you are seeing which are made up of materials. So materials are the substances which are used for making these objects. Like cloths are made up of fabrics, okay, and paper is made up of wood pulp. Different objects are made up of different materials and they have different properties. Yes, so we use our senses to feel the materials. Yes, so like smell, okay, we can see the objects. See, these materials are occurring, naturally occurring materials and man-made materials. In this material we can classify it into two types. Yes, so different object can be made from the same material. Okay, by using the, we can make some same object can also be made from different materials like plastic. Yes, see, plastic chair, wooden chair, iron chair. Yes, so the object is same but the material which we are using to make this object are different. Yes, so this plastic is made up of plastic, okay, and this which is made up of wood and this is made up of metals. Yes, so by using this, so same object can also be made from the different materials. Yes, so the objects which we are seeing around us now that are made up of what? Materials. See, now we know that different objects can be made from same material, same object can be made from different materials. An object can be made by combination of different materials. Okay, some of the objects which can be made from, which can be made by the combination of different materials. Yes, we can make such objects by the combination of different materials, like knife. Yes, so knives which are made up of plastic and also the metal. Yes, see, can we make hammer from glass? Can we make a hammer from glass? Of course not. Why? Because no, we cannot make hammer from glass. Why? Because it broke. So can we use wax nails instead of iron nails? Can we use these that is wax nails instead of iron nails? No. Yes, no. See, what factors decide which material should be used for making an object? What are the factors that decide that which material should be used for making a particular object? What is the factor? That is, the choice of the material used for making an object depend on its properties and purpose for which the object is to be made. Okay, how can we choose the material by used for making an object depend on its the property? Okay, some are very hard, some are very smooth. Yes, so we cannot hit a nail by plastic things. Yes, we cannot hit onto wall, that is nail, by use, we cannot use the plastic things. Okay, it needs some hammer which is made up of only the metals. Yes, why? Because it is very hard. Okay, and plastic is very lightweight, so by with the help of plastic we cannot hit the hammer, we cannot hit the nail. Yes, so due to that reason we can choose the material based on their properties and purposes for which the object is to be made. See, like properties, what are the properties of materials? See, these are the some properties of materials, that is the appearance. Appearance means the physical aspect, that is what we see through our eyes. Okay, and the hardness and transparency. Transparency means through which we can see other objects. Okay, the object through which we can see other objects like glass. Yes. See, next is what? Solubility. Solubility means dissolving. Okay, in a glass of water when you add a sugar, means what will happen? It will become dissolved. Okay, and some object cannot be dissolved. When you add a salt in a water, means it cannot dissolve. Okay, so these are the some materials. Based on these materials we choose the materials for the to make the objects. What is the, let us discuss this about one by one. The first property is what? Appearance. See, appearance of the substances. Look at around you. See, the object which you are seeing, some are made up of what? Yes, see, metal vase, glass vase, wooden vase and plastic vase. So these are all vases are same, the object is same, but the material which you use it to make are different. Yes, see, these are the varieties of vases that you can see. This is what the metal vase and this is what wooden vase. Yes, so vase is same, the object is same, but the material which is used to make it is different. Okay, so what is this appearance? Appearance is that what? The color, the luster, the texture and the physical state of the object, it indicates this. Okay, the color of different materials, look at this, these are the different colors. This gold having a different color and this copper, it has the different color. Yes, so these are what? The man-made materials that we can see the physical state, that is the color, texture. Yes, the shape, the size. So these are what? Rubber balls. Yes, the shiny, some object can appearance like a shiny. Okay, but some object does not shiny. Yes, so these objects are shiny. So the material having shiny appearance are known as lustrous materials. Okay, and lustrous materials, for example, that is gold and silver. And some materials having dull appearance are known as non-lustrous. Here lustrous means shine. Okay, so the objects which you are seeing now, that are what? See texture. See, look at these objects which are which is a smooth texture, and this one is what? A rough texture. Having a, we can see around us in a different, see, and along with that we can see also the materials are in three states. Yes, that is solid, liquid and gaseous. Okay, so the objects which you are seeing now, this wood, and this is what? Liquid state. The wood is solid state, the liquid state. Yes. And the another one is, that is air. Air is what? The gaseous state. And this is what? The gaseous state, the air which is the atmosphere which is surrounding our earth. Okay, so that is what? The gaseous state. So this is the three states of water. This is what? Like ice. Okay, so ice is what? The solid state. When it melts, it will become liquid state. And when we boil this water, the steam which we can see, that is what? The gaseous, the gaseous, that is state. So the water which we can see in three form, that is in solid state, liquid state, and that is another one is what? Gaseous state. So these are the three states of water that we can see. So children, around us there are the physical appearance. What are those? That what we can see through our eye, that is through our eyes, like color, okay, like shape, okay, like the appearance, how it looks, like it could be a appear, that is it could be a shine, some of the object cannot be shine. Yes, so these are all what? Appearance. So this is also what? The three states of matter, like gaseous state, liquid state, and the steam, that is another one is what? That is solid state. So these are the three states. These are what? The physical state, the physical appearance that we can see our eyes. See, dash have definite value but no definite shape. What are those? That is liquids. Yes, no? So liquids have a definite value but no definite shape. Okay, it has the capacity to occupy the space, that we are called it as what? Volume. Volume means the object occupies space. Yes, but they do not, the object do not have a definite shape. Okay, so liquids have a definite value, it occupies space, which means, and it does not have a definite shape. It has a value but do not have a definite shape. Okay, it take the shape of the container. Okay, so you pour water in glass means the water take the glass shape. Yes, when you pour a water into bucket, it shape that it take the shape of bucket. Okay, therefore liquids do not have any definite shape but it has a definite value. Okay, it occupies some space. Yes, so silk cloth is dash to touch, it is smooth to touch. So this what? Liquid, smooth, shiny. So these are all what? These are all the properties of appearance, that is in a physical state. Next is what? Another one property of a material, that is what? Hardness. See here, look at, see, this is what? Helmet, and this is what? The teddy bear. Okay, so hard materials, they are difficult to compress. For example, that is steel, their shape cannot be easily changed by pressing. Yes, see, so the object which you are seeing, no, this is what? Helmet. It is a very hard. Yes, so this is very smooth to touch. Okay, so these hard materials means which they are difficult to compress. Hardness means it is getting very hard to compress the subject. For example, like steel. Okay, and their shape cannot be easily changed by pressing. Okay, we cannot change the hard substances, okay, by pressing. Okay, so the hardness means it is very tough to compress, and also it could be very hard to change its shape. Next is what? They can be compressed easily. That are what? Soft materials. Okay, so in this hardness and hard material and soft material, what is the difference between hard and soft? Soft means cannot be compressed easily. Hard materials cannot be compressed easily, whereas soft compressed easily. For example, hollow plastic ball. Okay, so the and also the cotton. So these are the some example that we can compress easily. That we are called it as what? Soft materials. And their shape can be easily changed by pressing. Okay, we can change their shapes by pressing it. Okay, like let's you take the balloon. Okay, by pressing it, we can change in a different shape. Yes. So or by pulling or by cutting. So by pulling also we can change the shape, and by cutting also we can shape the chain. So this is how the difference between the hard materials and soft materials. Okay, around us we can see such a materials like tables, okay, benches. Yes, so many other objects that we can use. So some object cannot be changes, it could be very hard or it could be very difficult to change its shape. And also, and some of the object we can easily come, we can easily change the shapes. That subject which we are, that objects which we are called it as what? Soft material. So these are the some properties of the materials. Okay, some of the properties having hardness, and some objects have the property that is softness. Next is what? The floating property of objects. See, objects lighter and heavier than water. Yes, the some objects which we can see around us, some of the objects which are very light or which are very heavy enough under the water. Look at, see, so this is what the board which you might have played. Yes, so these are the objects which are very lightweight. So, and the object, some object which are steel spoon, which are hard substance, and mustard oil, so stones, and this plastic balls. Look at these objects, leaves, and see, these are the some objects. When we put these objects on the top of the water, means which objects float and which object sink, that is sink, sorry. See, we take one ice cream. Yes, we take one ice cream wood, that is when we pour this, when we put this in the water, means it does not sink. Instead of that, it could be float. So when we take the nail, what will happen? It becomes sink. Okay, and the gloves, okay, see, the this gloves, does it sink? No, it could be float. Okay, the object like spoon, okay, it is also get sink. So, and will a coin float or a sink in water? That is, of course, why? Because it is a metal and hard and heavy subject, heavy object, that it could be sink. And the stone, it is also sink in the water. Yes. So now you can classify that which object can be float and which object can be sink. Okay. See, there are many objects are there that some object could be float on the water, on the surface, and some object sink in the water. See, here pouring the, that is what, oil. What happens? Look at this. See, it is floating on the water. Yes. Now you see, so the object heavier than water, so like coin, spoon, stone, and nails. So these are what, these objects are heavier than the water. Okay, so object that will float and the object that will sink. Objects that will float on the water, on the surface of the water, and the object will sink in the water. those objects which are lighter than water, it could be float on the water. Whereas the object which are heavier than the water, these object sink in the water. Like wooden stick, plastic globe, and plastic ball, leaf, mustard oil. So these are what? These are lighter than the water. So these object which float on the water, whereas the object which are heavier than the water, which sink in the water. So these are the some examples of that the object. This is one of the property that some object can float, some object can be sink in the water. See, an object will float or sink in water depending on whether it is lighter or heavier than the water. So depending on the property of that object, we can say that the object is it float or sink. Okay, see, materials which are lighter than the water that can be float on the water, for example, that is plastic, pencil and etc. And the materials which are heavier than the water, which sink in the water, like either nail and steel, etc. Children, you must have seen earthen lamps. Can you make a lamp which floats on water? Let us try it making. Okay. See, here is one of the we need some things to make this, like twist off cap of a bottle, cotton wick and transparent container, oil, water and pair of scissors, matchstick. Okay, to make that we need these objects. See, like the first we will start with, punch a hole in the bottle's cap and lodge enough a rolled up sheet of tissue paper to pass through. Okay. Next, take a long cotton wick and pass 1/8 of it and throw one side of the cap. Next, fill the bowl with water and oil in such a way that the oil is more than half an inch deep or deeper than the long side of your wick. Next, place the cap afloat on the oil. Let the wick soak up the fuel. So set it on fire and enjoy the light. Okay, so that is how we can make a design, that is candle, that is what? The lighting candle. Okay, so by using such objects. Why? Because why it is possible? Because the oil is there, no? It is what? Lighter than the water. Okay, due to that reason it is float on the water. By using this property we can make a beautiful light, yes, candle. So what have we learned from this activity about the nature of water and oil? Okay, what we have learned? Why? Because oil is insoluble in water and it is lighter than the water. So this is one of the property of, that is, some object can float on the water, in the water, on the water, and some object which sink in the water. So let us see, a wooden cork dash water. The wooden cork, does it sink or float on the water? That is, of course, your answer should be float on the water. Okay, a metal key, does it float or sink? That is, this is a very hard subject and it is very heavier than the water. Due to that reason, it sinks in the water. Okay. So, the continuation part of this lesson we will discuss in next video. Okay. Until that, you prepare this lesson.